My mother died of pancreatic cancer, and at that time there wasn't many options.
I've had a number of patients that come to me and sort of say, I've got this diagnosis of pancreas cancer, I know there's no hope, I know I'm gonna die.
When I was a medical student, I had a patient that had a new diagnosis of pancreatic cancer, and I was struck by how we didn't really have anything at the time to offer that individual, and I sort of told myself at that time, I'd like to do something about this disease.
The perception of pancreatic cancer is that it's a death sentence, that people don't live very long. That's actually not the whole story.
There's so much happening in the field right now. We look at multiple different aspects of pancreatic cancer to try to find different areas that make the tumor vulnerable. So that includes looking at the tumor microenvironment, the immune system, the vasculature, the fibroblasts, and other potential areas of vulnerability.
My work actually derives from things that are being studied in the lab in pancreatic cancer models, mouse models, for example, and then going from that lab finding right to the clinic as soon as we possibly can.
My research specifically focuses on genetic pancreatic cancers. The Basser Center is a huge research and clinical enterprise that is seated within Penn, and the focus of the center is to improve the recognition of disease, the screening for diseases, and then the treatments of specific diseases that are associated with the genes BRCA1, BRCA2, and others that are similar.
My research is in both the inherited and somatic genetics of cancer. We work specifically to try to understand the molecular features of BRCA1 and 2 associated tumors and how they may be associated with response to therapy.
It's one of the cancers where targeted therapy historically has not been terribly successful, but in the last couple of years, we've noticed that specific types of chemo work the best for those patients, and if you give the right chemo, that the patients will live much longer. And then even more recently has shown that PARP inhibitors also are effective for this particular group of patients. It's clearly not the end of the story, but now we have something to start to build on.
Without that research, we're going to be stuck in the mud, and with pancreatic cancer research, we'll be able to understand molecular details that will not only allow us to have improved therapies for a small fraction of patients, but for all patients.
And we're allowing them to live longer and live better. And that's ultimately our goal with pancreas cancer.
We're always trying to seek better options for patients to help better control and cure pancreas cancer.
In the time since I started in pancreatic cancer, the survival has almost doubled.
And so it's important to make sure that the general public is educated and understands the availability of therapies, the importance of clinical trials.
Our slogan here at the Penn Pancreatic Cancer Research Center is hope for all stages. A patient who is diagnosed at whatever stage, we want to be able to offer them hope in the form of a clinical trial, something that will advance knowledge and also give them the potential for a better outcome.
It's a disease where we have an extraordinary unmet medical need and where we can make an extraordinary difference, and that's why I love working on it.